In this illustration, we'll be analyzing a rotating tilted rod. Here the figure shows a thin uniform rod AB of mass M and length L rotating about the vertical axis OO' at angular velocity omega. Here we are required to find the torque of centrifugal forces acting on rod about the midpoint of the rod C in the frame of reference rotating at angular speed omega attached to the axis OO'. So in this situation here, to analyze the centrifugal forces which act only in the rotating frame of reference, here we can redraw the figure of rod and analyze on it. And we can see different points of the rod are at different distances from the axis of rotation OO'. So we consider an element at a distance x from the center and it is of width dx. For this element, if we consider its mass, we can write mass of an element taken as shown is, this we can write as m by L multiplied by dx, and this element is considered to be revolving in a circle of radius. If this angle is theta, then its radius r can be written as x sine theta. So in this situation, we can say the centrifugal force on element due to its circular motion is the centrifugal force dF, we can write, which is acting in outward direction, and the value of dF we can write as dm omega square r. The value of r we can substitute as x sin theta, so this dm omega square x sin theta. Now if we calculate the torque due to dF on rod about C is, this can be written as d tau, and that will be equal to dF multiplied by this distance. Here we can see from point C, the line of action of dF is x cos theta. So this can be written as dFx cos theta. If we substitute the value of dF, this will be dm omega square x square sin theta cos theta. So if this is the torque acting on the rod due to the centrifugal force on element about C, here we can write total torque on rod for all the centrifugal forces, we can write as integration of d tau. And here dm also we can substitute as m by l dx, then this will give us m by l omega square x square sin theta cos theta dx, and we integrate it within limits from minus l by 2 to plus l by 2. Here all constants can be taken out, which are m omega square by l sin theta cos theta, and this integration of x square dx from minus l by 2 to plus l by 2, which gives, on integrating this becomes x cube by 3, and this m omega square by l sin theta cos theta multiplied by its integration is x cube by 3, and we substitute limits from minus L by 2 to plus L by 2. If you numerically calculate this value after substitution of limits, then this will give us 1 by 3 M omega square by L sin theta cos theta multiplied by, if we put the limits, then this will be L cube by 8. This minus minus plus L cube by 8. And this will be equals to, on solving we get 1 by 12 m omega square l square sine theta, cos theta, which is the result of this problem.